Bolt action. Battle report. First encounter in Normandy, day 2. The inexperienced second lieutenant was to take charge for the second day, with his original platoon taken back to full strength, with fresh recruits off the beaches of Normandy. His forces were also bolstered by an additional paratrooper section, a quick-firing six-pounder, and a Cromwell cruiser tank. Feeling confident from the previous day's victory, the lieutenant boarded the M5 half-track with the new paratrooper section and entered the hamlet down the main road. Flanked on the left and the right by the other paratrooper sections. However, the German Fallschirmjäger had also been regrouping and now had at disposal two SDK 251 half-tracks, which entered the hamlet in a pincer movement. To his horror, the second lieutenant watched as a Panzer IV tank came into view over a small hill. It took aim at his half-track, hitting it squarely on the front. But fortunately, the round passed straight through the vehicle. Shaken, the lieutenant hurriedly called in an artillery barrage, which had been so effective and decisive on day one. In his haste to coordinate an effective barrage, the shells fell short of the hamlet, pinning his advancing forces. So he shouted at the driver to gun the engine and drive out of the hamlet. The QF six-pounder engaged the Panzer tank, and the British Cromwell moved up to support the lieutenant as he raced through the hamlet.
I'm a piercing! Ready!
Fire!
Turning the last corner, he was stopped in his tracks by one of the SDK 251 half-tracks and came under heavy fire. Seeing the lieutenant's predicament, the Cromwell tank moved forward and almost broke the German forces surrounding the M5 half-track. But a Panzerschreck team hidden in the bocage zeroed in on the brave British tank and swiftly dispatched it with a second aimed shot.
Achtung!
Crashing through the barrage and into the hamlet main street, the panzer tank turned its turret and put an end to the 2nd Lieutenant's short-lived command as the M5 half-track exploded with the loss of all of those inside. During this manoeuvre, the QF6 Pounder and remaining British paratroopers were kept pinned by the advancing German Fallschirmjäger units. Although a brave Piat team made one last attempt to stop the Panzer IV, the shaped charge was to miss the tank. It was only a matter of time now before the turret of the advancing tank was to swing back towards the remaining paratroopers and QF6 Pounder to sweep them from the hamlet.